Assemblyman, I know, look, this has been an issue you've cared a lot about for a long time, and I'll get to that. You and I talked about it back last summer. But please tell me about this call with the governor.
Oh, good to see you, Erin. This happened last Thursday evening around 8 o'clock after news broke that his top aide had lied about hiding data and information from the federal government for political reasons. She admitted to that in a private meeting, and it was exposed. And the governor called for about 10 minutes, it seemed like 1 hour, berating, yelling, and threatening that I have to issue a statement that invalidated what I heard. He asked me to lie to cover up for his staff. And this was done in front of my family. He called me. My wife was right next to me. I was right about to bathe my kids. And it really just put my family and my wife into shock and trauma for many hours, and she couldn't get any sleep that night. And it's highly inappropriate, for the governor to have done that.
So he said he can destroy you. I mean, he literally said that. And what else?
He said, I haven't seen his anger. I haven't seen his wrath. And he will, just tell me, he will go out, and he's been biting his tongue, but he will go out tomorrow and destroy my political career, my, everything. Like, he would say how bad of a person I am to everyone in public. But it was just the yelling. And at one point he said, and he asked me if I was a lawyer. And I said, no. And he said, you obviously then don't understand what you heard. And this is what you heard. And this is what you're going to say. This is what you're going to write tonight and issue a statement, not tomorrow, tonight. That's how we will move forward. Those are his words.
It's stunning. It's stunning. I mean, so let me just give everyone a chance to understand. As you know, they're pushing back on this. Cuomo's senior advisor just put out a statement tonight, Assemblyman Kim, and it says in part, Mr. Kim is lying about his conversation with Governor Cuomo Thursday night. I know because I was one of the three other people in the room when the phone call occurred, obviously on the governor's side. At no time did anyone threaten to, quote, destroy anyone with their, quote, wrath, nor engage in a cover-up. That's beyond the pale and is unfortunately part of a years-long pattern of lies by Mr. Kim against this administration. And then they put out a rushed transcript of comments you made during the Zoom call with Cuomo's aide. They say they don't align with what you're saying now. What's your response to them? They're calling you a liar.
Well, I think Governor Cuomo is very good at implicating his aides, and he's been trying to implicate me. They did implicate us in that private meeting when his secretary, Melissa DeRosa, admitted to obstruction of justice, of hiding information in fear that it would be weaponized against the administration, in fear that we will go back and legislate and repeal legal immunity, the stuff that you and I have been talking about for months now, yep. In fear that we would undo all the policies. That's why they cover up the data. And she admitted it. She said, you want the truth? This is the truth. And she said that she hid that information. That was what the governor did. And because I called out, because I refused to lie for them, now they get to threaten my career, my wife, and made my wife, in tears all night. My wife, that night was very, very troubling because we couldn't sleep. And she's telling me, what did you do to us? Stop what you're doing, please. She feared for my future, for my life. That's the kind of shock that this governor gave to my family, and his administration should be apologizing to me right away, not spinning and distracting us from getting to the truth.
Assemblyman Kim, I appreciate your time, and I want everyone to know it is true. You have cared about this issue about nursing homes. You were on the show in May. In May, he was on the show talking about this very issue. Thanks very much to you. And I want everyone to know we did invite Governor Cuomo and his senior advisor onto the show to discuss this tonight. They declined.